Alrighty guys, welcome back to Dan in the Dirt. First and foremost, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment. And stay busy, stay dirty, guys. So let's get into this. So, we had bought, now this is the Duralast one, because we had to get it local because I needed it right away. But I had bought the ACdelcos brand, but apparently, apparently both of them have this issue. I was having an issue where when I would turn this older style GM headlight switch on, I have the knob removed right now. There's a little detent for it. Anyway, when I would turn the switch on, none of my dash lights, or, you know, for the gauges and for the speedometer, as you can see, are now on. Wouldn't come on, neither would the cab lights, as you can see. So I'm going to go up here on the roof. I have the truck covered because it's I need shade because it's uber hot in the 90s. But as you guys can see, it wouldn't turn on my cab lights, and they're all on now. And add it wired to the constant hot wire to turn my dome light on, which I'm also going to rig it up to allow my dome light to be turned on and off by the door switches. But we'll get to that in another video. So this main power feed to this GM switch that I had decided to use will only power the headlights. You have to run a little jumper wire to one of the two orange wires in this harness in order for it to backfeed in to give everything else power, which I didn't know. So we actually ended up replacing the ACdelcos switch, seeing it was defective, with a Duralast switch. Which it's the SW144, so you guys can check that out for yourself if you have this issue. But like I said, you guys can see I have a custom fuse block, you know, like that. And I'm running LED lights as far as marker lights and in the cabin stuff. And I have like the relay, all that stuff. So this wiring and stuff has been quite fun to have to figure out on my own. Guys, if you're doing custom wiring, make sure you have a voltmeter. I just got a little cheap one here, but it definitely helps me. So back to this. Make sure that if you guys decide wire one of these switches in for a custom job, or maybe you're rewiring a GM that has this switch or whatever, that you run a power wire to one of those orange wires, guys, in this harness, as you can see right there. But anyway, guys. So that's what I wanted to share with you in this video. That was a gremlin that gave me quite a fit and some problems, and hopefully this video will help some of you not have the same issue to have to chase this down. Anyway, guys, again, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment, as it helps people find my content. Stay busy, stay dirty. We'll see you in the next one, guys.